We've just seen Josh go head-to-head with Dennis there. What are your initial thoughts, having seen him, you know, size each other up and go head-to-head?
Pretty much business as usual, really. He's going to come to fight. He thinks that he's not going to be intimidated by a crowd. As easier said than done, you know, you walk out in there. Don't forget, on TV it's all filtered out and it's drowned down so you can hear commentators. I think it'll be different on night. You know, it must be very, very intimidating. But at the same time, I'm going to take my hat off to him. You know, he's coming from Denmark. He's a good kid. He deserves to be there. This is no unpicked opponent. He's mandatory and it would order. So we've got to deal with him, you know.
It's one of them, Sean, isn't it? Because he's not a household name, this Dennis Ceylan, but he's a tough kid. He's been in there with Isaac Lowe, Ryan Walsh, you know. So, you know, he's the business, really, isn't he?
Absolutely. I mean, he's not an household name here because, I mean, he's from Denmark. But in Denmark, he's very, very well known. He's beat Ryan Walsh. I watched that fight. I thought it was a brilliant performance from him. Dealt with Ryan Walsh fairly easy, I thought. Being in with Isaac Lowe, it was a shame that you know, injury stopped that fight, because it was warming up into a brilliant fight. I don't know how much that's going to do for his confidence, because that was his last fight. He's not fought since, and now he's got to come to Leeds and he's got to get in there, you know. I'm looking forward to it.
Absolutely. And Josh, just looking at Josh's body language today, he seems in a real sort of, you know, really, really switched on, possibly more than I've seen him before, actually.
He seems a little bit more serious today, doesn't he? He's not sure about Salt Light, but he does look...
Yeah, I'm not sure about the Sumo
I'm not sure about that. Peaky Blinder.
Look better on you.
It would look better on me. Obviously, I'm one of them that can wear out and, yeah, make exactly. make it look good. No, to be serious, he's got to be between his teeth now. I think what's needled him is the Lee Selby thing. They keep going on social media, him and his team. I mean, if I were Lee, I'd be looking at people now. I mean, I'd be embarrassed. I would be embarrassed. Any of my team came out with statements like that, fucking hell, there'd be murders, honestly. I'd be very, very disappointed. I can't understand it, that sort of behaviour. And what it's done is it's put a bit between his teeth. All this, you know, that we don't want the fight. Why are we fighting a final eliminator if we don't want that fight? Of course we want that fight. Frank offered him a phenomenal amount of money. The conditions that were attached to it were absolutely just nonsensical. You know, so why, if we don't want the Selby fight, are we fighting a final eliminator? I'll tell you why. They don't want it. They've never wanted it. All that business when, you know, they keep going on about his wedding and us wanting a change of dates. Eddie Hearn came to us and asked us, what dates can you do? We said, we can't do this date because that's the only one date that we can't do. That was it. From there, behave like idiots, really. Very unprofessional. We've always wanted that fight and he knows it. And now we are knocking on the door. And when, I'm telling you now, he's getting beat. And they know it. They know he's getting beat. That's why they attach terms that they try to attach.
And in a way, do you think Dennis Ceylan's going to pay, in a way, for the frustration that's been built up here?
Fucking absolutely.
Yeah.
He's going to pay for it. You know, and you know something? Looking at him today, very, very brave, but you can look at him. He knows he's going to pay. He knows he's got an handful, hasn't he? Yeah. And he knows it.
Mm. Yeah. And of course, anyone coming into Leeds to fight Josh is up against it anyway from the get-go, because the crowd is hostile.
It's like having an extra round, isn't it? You know, you've got that crowd behind you. It's, I mean, Leeds people are very, very passionate. You know, they get behind the rugby team, get behind the football team, which is a good job, really. Any other city that have gone bust, you know, they haven't sold a ticket either. But, Leeds as a city, it's booming now. You know, football teams turn things round, rugby teams slowly dragging things round. We've got the boxing knocking on the door at a world title. It's all going good. It's going good.
Sean, just on a final note, do you think we could see a stoppage from Josh on the 21st of October?
I don't like making predictions, because people ask me all the time, being in boxing game, how's this one going to go? And I always fucking get it wrong. Right. So what I'm going to say is, it'll be a good fight, scheduled for 12 rounds. I ain't bothered if it goes 12 or if it goes 2, it's that win that's important. Everyone seems to be a little bit obsessed by stoppages and knockouts, and I think... think that's the essence of boxing. The essence of boxing is watching two well-matched guys go head-to-head, and best man wins. So I'm not going to make any predictions. What I will say is we'll get that win. And we'll get that win, whatever we have to do to get it. We will get it. We've fought better fighters than Dennis. I don't mean any disrespect. We have fought better fighters. We've already been in world title class, you know, with Amagasa.
Kiko Martinez.
Kiko Martinez, who incidentally, he went at featherweight. We didn't boil him down to super bantam. You know, there were no short notice for a fight. 16-week training camp. Last chance alone for him. A weight above is a proper handful. And we dealt with him with one hand. No excuses. Take yourself into him. We got a bad injury second round, actually. There was a problem with his hand, and it was a very, very real problem. We still beat him with one hand. Whichever way this fight goes is the win that's important. And all I'm saying is, we will win 100%. Whatever it takes.
Sean, thanks a lot for your time. Really appreciate it.
It's a fucking pleasure.
Best of luck.
Thank you, mate.
Thanks.
Sorry, I swore again.
It's alright.